The sum of two numbers is 52 and their difference is 2, then the numbers are. So we could go by the option method here. Two conditions have to be met. First is the sum must be equal to 52, and second is the difference of the two numbers must be 2. Let's check with option A, 17 and 15. Now if we add the 2, 17 plus 15 is 32. So the first condition fails here, so option A doesn't work. Option B, 12 and 10. Now 12 plus 10, that's not equal to 52, that's 22. So option B also fails. Option C, 27 and 25. Now if we add, 27 plus 25 is equal to 52, so first condition is correct. And the difference, so 27 minus 25, the difference is also 2 over here. So the correct answer is option C. The diagonal of a rectangle is 5 centimeters and one of its sides is 4 centimeters, then its area is. So suppose this is the rectangle and the diagonal length is 5. This angle would be 90 degrees and one of the sides is 4 centimeters. Let us consider this as 4 and let this second side be x. Now, using the Pythagoras theorem, we know that x square plus 4 square will be equal to 5 square. So we have x square plus 16 is equal to 25. Therefore, x square will be equal to 9, and hence, if you take the square root, we have x is equal to 3. So this side is equal to 3, this one. So we have the adjacent sides. So therefore, the area of the rectangle will be length into breadth. That is 4. Length is 4. So 4 into 3, which is 12 square centimeters. So the answer is option B. Divide 56 into two parts such that 3 times the first part exceeds 1/3 of the second by 48. So 56 has to be divided into two parts. Suppose the first part is x, the second part would be 56 minus x. Now the condition is 3 times the first part, that is 3 times x, exceeds, that is, this is greater than 1/3 of the second part by 48. So 3x minus 1/3 of 56 minus x, that is 56 minus x upon 3, this difference is equal to 48. Now we simplify this. Now 3 into 3x, that's 9x minus 56 plus x divided by 3 is equal to 48. So 9x plus x, so that's 10x minus 56 is equal to, now if you multiply this, 8 threes is 24, that's 144. So 10x is equal to, now if we add, 10 carry 1 and that's 200. So x is equal to 200 by 10, which is equal to 20. And hence the two parts are, first part is x, that is 20, and second part will be 56 minus x, that is 56 minus 20, which is 36. So the answers are 20 and 36, which is option A. The sum of digits of a two-digit number is 10. If 18 be subtracted from its digits, in the resulting number, the digits in the resulting number will be equal. Then the number is, let's go by the option method. The first condition is the sum of digits must be 10. And if we subtract 18 from this number, if we subtract 18, then the resulting number will have equal digits. Okay, so here the digits will be equal. So equal digits. Let's check with the option. Option A, 37. Now if we add 3 plus 7, that is 10. So the first condition is satisfied. Now 37 minus 18, if we subtract this, we have 19. Now the digits are not equal over here, so this condition fails. Let's check with option B, 73. Now 7 plus 3 is 10, so this condition is satisfied. And 73 less 18, now if we subtract this, we get 55. So the digits are equal in this case. Yes, so the second condition is also met. So the answer is option B. The fourth part of a number exceeds the sixth part by 4, then the number is. So suppose the number is x, then its fourth part will be x by 4 and the sixth part will be x by 6. And the difference is given as 4. Now we solve this equation, we could easily obtain x. Now we equalize the denominators and the LCM is 12. 4 3s is 12, so in the numerator we have 3x. 6 2s is 12 and here 2 into x, that will be 2x is equal to 4. Now 3x minus 2x, that's x, and 12 4s is 48. So our required number is 48, which is option C. 10 years ago, the age of father was 4 times that of son. So we have 10 years ago, father's age was 4 times the son's age. And 10 years hence, 10 years hence or later, the age of father will be twice of that of son. The present ages of father and son are, now here we can go about with the option method. So suppose their present ages are 50 and 20. Now 10 years ago, father's age will be 40 and son's age will be, now 20 minus 10, that's 10. So we could clearly see father is 4 times the age of son. So first condition is satisfied. Now 10 years hence, we need to add 10 years. So 10 years hence, father will be 50 plus 10, that's 60. And son would be 20 plus 10, that's 30. So we could clearly see father is twice the age of son. So this condition is also satisfied. So the correct answer is option A. The product of two numbers is 3200 and the quotient when the larger number is divided by the smaller number is 2, then the numbers are. So two conditions have to be checked. The product must be equal to 3200 and if we divide the larger number by the smaller number, then the quotient is 2. Let's go by the option method. Option A is 16 and 200. Now 16 into 200 is 3200. So the first condition is okay. Then if 200 is divided by 16, this is definitely not equal to 2. So option A is not favorable. Then we have option B, 160 and 20. Now 160 into 20 is 3200. So first condition is satisfied. And 160 divided by 20, this is equal to 8. But we need a 2 over here. So this is not equal to 2. So option B is also incorrect. Option C is 60 and 30. Now 60 into 30 is 1800. So this condition is not met. So option C fails. So yes, the answer has to be option D. 80 and 40. Let us verify. So 80 into 40 is 3200. and 80 divided by 40 is equal to 2. So this is also met. So the correct answer is option D. The denominator of the fraction exceeds the numerator by 2. So if numerator is x, then the denominator will exceed it by 2. That is, it will be x plus 2. So this is our original fraction. Next, if 5 is added to the numerator, that is, if x increases by 5, numerator increases by 5, denominator remains the same. So the numerator is increased by 5, then the fraction, that is the original fraction, increases by unity. So our original fraction, that is x plus x by 2, this increases by unity. So what is the original fraction? Now we could easily solve this and obtain x. So we have x plus 5 by 2, sorry, x plus 5 by x plus 2 is equal to, now equalizing the denominator, we have x plus 2 upon x plus 2. So we could cancel out x plus 2. And here we have x plus 5. On the right hand side, we have 2x plus 2. Now 2x minus x, that's x. And 5 minus 2 is 3. So now we could get our original fraction. So original fraction will be 3 upon, now 3 plus 2 is 5. So the correct answer is 3 by 5, which is option D. 3 persons, Mr. Roy, Mr. Paul and Mr. Singh, together have rupees 51. Mr. Paul has rupees 4 less than Mr. Roy and Mr. Singh has got 5 rupees less than Mr. Roy. So suppose the amount received by Mr. Roy is X. Then the amount received by Mr. Paul, he has 4 rupees less. So this will be x minus 4. And Mr. Singh has got 5 rupees less than Mr. Roy. So his share would be x minus 5. And they have given that the total amount is 51. So from here we could get this equation. X plus x minus 4 plus x minus 5 is equal to 51. So that's 3x minus 9 is equal to 51. So 3x is equal to 60. So x is equal to 20. So from here we could get the shares. Mr. Roy's share will be x, that's 20. Then Mr. Paul, 20 minus 4, that's 16, and 20 minus 5, that's 15. So 20, 16 and 15. So the correct answer is option A. A number consists of 2 digits. The digit in the tens place is 3 times the digit in the units place. And if 54 is subtracted from the number, the digits are reversed. Then the number is. Let us go by the option method. So we have the 2-digit numbers. So it will have a tens place and the units place. Next, they have given the digits in the tens place is 3 times the digit in the units place. And next is, if 54 is subtracted from the number. So if we subtract 54 from this original number, then the digits are reversed. Okay, so this is the condition. Let's check with the options. First option is say 39. So here units is 3 times the tens place. So the first condition is not satisfied. So option A is out. Option B, 92. Now 3 times of 2 is 6, right? So here we have 9. So this condition also fails. Option C, 93. So yes, 9 is 3 times of 3. So this condition is satisfied. Now from 93 we subtract 54. So if we do the subtraction, this becomes 39. See, the digits are reversed. 93 becomes 39. So this condition is met. So the correct answer is option C. One student is asked to divide a half of a number by 6 and the other half by 4 and then to add the two quantities. Instead of doing so, the student divides the given number by 5, and if the answer is 4 short of the correct answer, then the number was. So suppose the number was x, so its half value is divided by 6 and the other half is divided by 4, and then he needs to add these two. So that's the first condition. But instead of doing so, the student divides the number by 5. That is, the number x is straight away divided by 5. And the difference of these two is 4. So difference of these two values or these two operations is 4. So let's go by the option method. If I say 320, if we split into half, that will be 160 and 160. So 160 by 6 plus 160 by 4 minus the number by 5. That's 320 by 5. Let us see whether this is equal to 4. Now 160 divided by 6 is 26.66 plus this will be 40, and 320 divided by 5 is 64. So definitely this won't be equal to 4 because of the decimals. Let's go by 400, option B. Now 400, if we split into two halves, it will be 200 200. Let us check. 200 by 6 plus 200 by 4 minus 400 by 5. Now 200 divided by 6 is 33.33, and this, if we divide, this would be 50 and this would be 80. Again, if you see, there are decimals here, so this will not be equal to 4. Option C, 480. That's the last thing. So 480, if we split into two parts, so 240. So we just verify 240 by 6 plus 240 by 4 minus 480 by 5. Now this one would be 40, this will be 60, and 480 divided by 5 is 96. So that's 100 minus 96, which is equal to 4. So yes, the correct answer is option C. If a number of which the half is greater than 1/5 of the number by 15, then the number is. So suppose the number is x, its half value is greater than its 1/5 value by 15. That is, the difference between these two is 15, then the number is. Now we could easily solve this. This would be 5x minus 2x upon 10 is equal to 15. So 3x is equal to 150. So x is equal to 50. So the correct answer is option A.